the world. But it couldn't fill me.
Welcome back to Journey. I'm Ray.
And I'm Greg.
And we have been going through Jesus' Sermon on the Mount. It begins in Matthew chapter 5. And he gives all these principles for how Christ followers need to reflect themselves in character and action in the kingdom of God. And we call this series Blessed because of that. And so today's blessed comes from Matthew 5:5. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth.
And this word meek can be translated as gentle. But now what we don't mean, though, is weak necessarily. And right. Also what we don't mean, I think what Jesus means here is like not defending yourself if you're being attacked or that sort of thing. So there's a lot of things we need to understand about this word and what Jesus is talking about here.
It's not the opposite of being bullied, though.
Correct.
Okay, right. So yes. How do you think people perceive being meek?
Well, I think in our world, it's kind of looked down upon, that you almost like a wimp in some ways. Like, it's not perceived very well. And, you know, if someone is not able to defend themselves, they're perceived as weak in that sense. So it depends on who you're asking. But in terms of our world, it kind of has a negative connotation to it, I'd say.
I mean, if people are reading this passage, they're thinking, okay, not so much. I don't want to be meek. Like right. The other things, maybe I'll be. So,
like, meek is not going to get you anything.
Well,
you want stuff, right?
Oh, all the time.
And they think meek won't get you stuff. But
being tough will?
Being tough will, yeah.
Okay, so what is Jesus saying here? I mean, how do meek people inherit the earth?
Right. Well, I think, like, when we look at Scripture, the word meek, it's best understood as gentle or humble. And literally a refusal to control someone or something for manipulative purposes or in a like brute force, that sort of thing. And, you know, meekness from the Christ follower's perspective really is trusting in God. That's really what it all boils down to.
Well, let's get back into the Old Testament for a minute. So David was a little shepherd boy,
yeah.
And he ended up being pushed to the front of the crowd in a sense. And was David being meek when he took Goliath down?
I think he was, totally. Like, and because you see in that story, David was not trusting in himself. He was trusting in God. And that's really what it boils down to. And, you know, I think the concept often is referred to as, you know, when we talk about humility, well, it can be mistaken as strength seeking control, but really it's strength under control.
Wow. So that's really exactly backwards from how the world sees it. The world sees it this way. I did it my way. The world sees the tough guy getting ahead.
Mm-hmm.
The world sees the manipulative and the very powerful who gain control at all cost. That's what they are thinking when they are thinking of who will inherit the earth.
Right, and Jesus, he does this really well. You know, the kingdom economics, he kind of flips things around. And,
right.
And that's so important for us to understand that it's these gentle, this meek, this humble people that are going to inherit the earth. And, you know, when Jesus is talking about this, it's important that he's talking about people that are trusting and believing in him. And that being said, that, you know, meekness is not necessarily something that is a requirement for being saved, but it absolutely is something that that is produced from the life of someone who genuinely is following Jesus.
And there's a proverb that goes with that.
Yes, and I love this proverb. It says, "It is better to be humble in spirit with the lowly than to divide the spoil with the proud." I just love that passage.
You know, I saw a picture this week online. I'm kind of a World War II nut, but it was this soldier in Germany, an American soldier, as they were going through Germany, and he was giving a chocolate bar to a little girl. She was all dirty, and you could tell she had been orphaned or at least disassociated from her parents at the time. But here's this big, strong, tough soldier treating this child with dignity and respect. True meekness takes courage.
Yeah.
It takes a truly courageous person to live with meekness. Releasing our desires to God is a part of allowing God's meekness and strength to shine through us. The New Testament says this, but he gives more grace. Therefore, it says, God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble.
And I love this quote by Howard Carter, and it says this: meekness is hanging on the cross when you could have summoned legions of angels to destroy us all. Meekness is Jesus. And Jesus being the creator of all things, and everything culminates in Jesus, we see that he could have done whatever he wanted when he was on the cross, but yet he remained there. He was humble, he was meek for the ultimate goal that, you know, we might be saved. And there's nothing better than that, what he's done for us.
Absolutely. Jesus is always the cleanest and best example, the highest example of what all these Beatitudes really truly mean. It takes courage to do this, but trusting God is where meekness begins. Are you willing to release your life to him in such a way that he can develop in you a spirit of kindness, a spirit of gentleness, a spirit of meekness? That's really our point today with this Beatitude. Thank you so much for listening. We'll see you soon on another journey.